So many of you guys on Instagram ask me what to do and what to study to become a roboticist, what bachelor, what master, so I decided to make this video to answer to all of you. We'll jump into this right now. Robotics is an interdisciplinary branch of engineering and science that includes mechanical engineering, electronic engineering, information engineering, computer science, control theory, psychology, and many others. So it's clearly impossible to specialize in every field, and it's better if you start focusing on a few of them from the very beginning while having just a general idea on what the others consist of. I'd say that we can group all the required competencies into main categories: hardware and software. Hardware concerns everything about the design and realization of a robot. Electronics and mechanics are fundamental. Robots all have some kind of mechanical construction, form or shape, designed to achieve a particular task, and they also have electrical components which power and control the machinery. Software is about all the robot can do. All robots contain some level of computer programming code. A program is how a robot decides when or how to do something. And robots that use artificial intelligence, for example, interact with their environment on their own and can determine reactions to objects and problems they encounter using their pre-existing programming. So it'd be wiser if you decide from the very beginning which one you want to go for, software or hardware. If you're really interested in the hardware, I suggest you to first get a bachelor in electronics, mechanical engineering, mechatronics, or design engineering. The bachelor just gives you a general overview on many subjects, so then you need a Master of Science to increase your knowledge in some specific areas. The Master of Science is really important, guys. In fact, the bachelor knowledge is not sufficient for you to become a good roboticist, and I don't even think it's enough for you to get a job. Getting a bachelor is like reading the introduction of a book, so it's pretty useless if you really want to understand the book, you know? So with a Master of Science, then you can get a robotics engineer job where you can provide technical support to the robotics team, or you can start being a researcher in robotics, experimenting more innovative and completely new things. We can talk about the pros and cons of being an engineer versus researcher in another video, I guess. So to resume, the perfect path for someone interested in making robots would be to get one of the bachelors that I suggested, then a Master of Science that specializes in some particular areas of electronics, mechatronics, or design. An example could be having a bachelor in electronics and then starting a Master of Science in embedded systems. So what's important though is that during your studies you get some practical knowledge on robotics. Yeah, it's not said that you're gonna get it from the exams. Don't worry, it's normal. In fact, the exams force you to acquire some important technical background that is very unlikely you get on your own, because it can get pretty lame. Really lame, it sucks sometimes. So be sure you start building basic electronic circuits. You can start with things as simple as lighting up an LED, then try more and more complex things by applying the theoretical concepts you acquired during your studies. You can learn basic assembling, so learn to make some basic structures using wood, acrylic, fiber, or plastic, and learn 3D printing. Start printing your own components, first replicating some already existing projects online, and then experimenting new design on your own. It would be cool if you can also integrate the above concepts with microcontrollers and try and test them on basic microcontrollers. The most popular choice among hobbyists and beginners is to go with Arduino. That's great and very simple. So learn CAD. You might be interested to develop and design complex robots, so start learning 3D design software such as Blender or SolidWorks, so that you can design your own robots. Well, these are only suggestions. You don't have to develop all these skills. I mean, if you do, better, but not all of them are strictly necessary. So I guess we can wrap up here with the hardware part. If you want to focus on the software part instead, you should first get a bachelor in computer science or automation engineering, and then you can get a Master of Science in artificial intelligence and robotics, or cognitive robotics, or automation and robotics. Among the competencies that you should develop, there are strong programming skills in C++ and or Python, and confidence in using a Linux operating system. In fact, a lot of libraries, packages, and software developed for robotics are distributed very easily and efficiently on Linux environments. So start downloading and installing Ubuntu on your computer and practicing with it. that learned some physics and linear algebra that are really important to control robots, and probability that is fundamental in machine learning as well. And it would be nice also if you can play with Arduino and or Raspberry Pi. And if you have a basic understanding of mechanics and electronics, this in fact can help you interact with the robots you're programming, understanding their potential and limits, and eventually fixing them when they break, because they will break many, many times. And get familiar with ROS, the robot operating system. That's an excellent middleware, and it's full of tutorials online, so you should have no problems. And you can also simulate robots that you don't even have, so it's great. Well, these are only suggestions, so you can also become an expert also without following all of these suggestions. And it's not a problem if you change your mind during your studies and switch to another area of interest. You can also come from a totally different field, completely different background, and nothing is gonna stop you from becoming an excellent roboticist anyways if you want. So that said, I hope this might help some of you guys, and good luck!
I hope you guys liked it. If so, hit the like button, subscribe, ring that bell so to know when more videos like this are out. It helps us out so much. I'll see you there.